Students, in this video session we are going to learn about river boat concept and problems related with river boat concept. Now let us see river boat concept in one dimension. First we will discuss about one dimension and then we will learn about two dimensional motion also. In this figure, it is been shown, this is velocity of river. This is velocity of river and this is velocity of boat. And here velocity of the river and this is velocity of the boat. Right? This is case one and this is case two. In the first case, or I don't want to make it complicated, I'll take that only as case one. This is case one and this is case two. So in the first case, river and boat, both are traveling opposite to each other. Boat velocity is opposite to that of river velocity. That is in first case one. In case two, boat velocity and river velocity are in the same direction. Both are traveling in the same direction. So for example, let us first see velocity of the boat is equal to zero. Velocity of the river is not equal to zero. Now there is a boat in a river. Velocity of the boat is not equal to zero. And you have a boat here. This boat velocity is zero because it is not being driven. This velocity of this individual boat is zero, and there is a person observing the boat. As boat is not on the ground, boat is not exactly on the ground. This boat is on river frame. Person is on the ground. Person is on the ground. Boat is on the river frame. So for this person, if he now observes the boat, boat could not be in rest position. Boat does not remains in rest as it is on the river frame. Velocity of the boat is appeared to be as velocity of river. So in this case, what would happen? For this person, velocity of the boat is exactly equal to velocity of the river. Velocity of the boat is equal to velocity of the river because individually boat does not have any particular velocity. Boat get drifted in the direction of river. That is first case. Boat is carried by river current. It itself will be going with the river. So that is what we have discussed. We will be seeing in case one. Now come to case. This is first thing. Now come to next case where velocity of the boat not equal to zero. Velocity of the river not equal to zero. VB is opposite to VR. VB is opposite to VR. This is known as upstream. It is known as upstream. What is meant by upstream? If the direction of velocity of the boat is opposite to the direction of velocity of the river, you call it as upstream. Now in case of upstream, what actually happens? This is river and there is a boat. Boat is traveling with velocity VB. River is traveling with velocity VR. Of course, I told you that VB is opposite to river velocity. Therefore, this is VB, right? So VB and VR both are opposite to each other. So in this case, what would happen? If a person is observing from the ground, for this person, even though boat is traveling in opposite direction to that of velocity of the river, the resultant speed of the boat is appeared as the difference between river velocity and boat velocity. The net velocity of the boat get difference of VB and VR. Suppose if boat is traveling with a speed of 10 meter per second, river is traveling with a speed of, river is with 5 meter per second. For this person who is observing from the ground, the net velocity of the boat is appeared as only 5 because it is 10 minus 5. Both are opposite to each other. Therefore, you can write velocity of the boat with respect to river is equal to velocity of boat minus velocity of the river. If both are opposite to each other, then the difference is the resultant velocity. That is number two. Now come to number three. Velocity of the boat not equal to zero. Velocity of the river not equal to zero. VB is parallel to VR. This is known as downstream. This is known as downstream. Downstream in the sense both river and boat, both are traveling in the same direction. Say this is river velocity VR and there is a boat in the river. Boat is also traveling with speed VB in the direction as that of the river velocity. In such cases, what would happen? A person who is observing from the ground, for this person, the net velocity of the boat appears as sum of river velocity and boat velocity. Because it increases, it is being carried with the river and therefore it is downstream and this is upstream. In downstream, what would happen to VBR? Velocity of the boat with respect to river is equal to velocity of the boat plus velocity of the river. Clear? So if both are traveling in the same direction, then in such cases it is called downstream, and in downstream net velocity is summed. Whereas in case of upstream, net velocity is the difference between boat velocity and river velocity. For the person who is on the ground, net velocity of the boat appears to be as decreased in case of upstream. If there is no boat velocity, boat is carried away with the river. In such cases, for a person who is on the ground, boat velocity is equal to river velocity. This is purely in one dimension. This case which we have discussed, it is purely in one dimension. In one dimension, boat is either traveling in the same direction as that of river as or in opposite direction as that of the river. In such cases, either it can be summed up or difference. That depends upon the direction of boat with respect to river. This is case one, where boat and river are traveling parallel to each other or opposite to each other, but in one dimension. In the first slide, we have learned that boat and river, they are purely traveling in one dimension, that is either positive x-axis or negative x-axis. Now coming to second case, like we are considering this as case one here. We need to cross the river in the shortest time and boat is traveling perpendicular in this case. And this is two dimension. Boat and river both are traveling in different directions. So this comes under 2D. Velocity of the boat is perpendicular to velocity of the river. Velocity of boat and velocity of the river both are perpendicular to each other. Now let me consider, here is point A. Boat is starting at point A. This boat should start at point A and it should reach actually at point B. It should reach at point B. For that, what boat is doing? Boat is rowing perpendicular to the river velocity. River velocity is in this direction. Boat velocity is perpendicular to the river velocity. Now in this case, boat does not reach position B Instead, it reached position C because of river velocity. It is similar to rain droplet carried by the wind velocity. If suppose rain droplet is about to fall down, this is rain droplet velocity. If there is wind in this direction, what would happen? Rain droplet would get drifted in this direction, right? In the same way, here also, boat is carried by the river velocity. Boat is actually starting at point A, but it is about to start and it should travel towards this point B. But instead, because of river velocity, it is carried to point C, right? And this is length X traveled. BC is length X, and this is AB length Y, right? Now let me consider BC is equal to drift of boat. This I am writing it as X. Next, AB is equal to width of the river. Width of the river, I am denoting it with W. And velocity of the boat is perpendicular to velocity of the river. In such case, what would happen? Boat drifts along river velocity. And this is downstream. It is downstream. As it is downstream, what would happen? The speed of the boat is a sum of river velocity and as well as boat velocity. Therefore, in this case, boat reach or boat cross the river. Boat crosses the river in shortest time. Shortest time, but longest path. Right? This is what you need to understand. It takes shortest time, but it is taking longer path. Where actually, in order to cross the river, it is actual point starting at A and it should reach B. But what is happening in this case? Boat is traveling to additional point C. It is traveling longer distance than that of the actual distance. Actual distance is equal to width of the boat, but width of the river. But what is happening in this case? It is traveling more distance, but it takes shortest time, right? It takes shortest time. Time taken is equal to distance traveled divided by speed of the boat, right? This is equation for time taken to cross the river. Time taken is equal to distance by speed of the boat. Why I am taking speed of the boat here is, boat velocity magnitude of VB is not changed here. VB magnitude is independent of, VB magnitude is independent of VR. Okay. This angle pi is dependent on the river velocity. If river velocity magnitude is less, in such cases, what would happen? Pi value would decrease. Suppose if river velocity magnitude increases, then pi value, it should increase. It may even greater than the value which is shown in this figure. Therefore, magnitude of boat velocity is independent of river velocity. That's the reason why time taken here, you can simply write it as width of river divided by velocity of the boat. Right? Now, in this case, whatever the velocity boat has, same velocity in the previous case also. Like if there is no river velocity, even then boat will take same time as that of this time. Clear? If there is no river velocity, boat would start at A and it would directly reach B position. In that case, whatever the time is taken, it is width of the river divided by boat, same time it take even if there is river velocity, but only the thing is it get drifted from point B to C. Right? So this is what the drift is being observed in the boat due to river velocity. In this case, what we have learned is, in order to row the boat, in the shortest time, like in order to reach, in order to cross the river in shortest time, you need to row the boat exactly perpendicular to river velocity. Then it will take short time, but longer length it takes, it is from A to C. And remember, the drift X only depends on river velocity. It is independent of boat velocity. And time is dependent on boat velocity. It is independent of river velocity. These points you need to remember when you are dealing with this kind of situation. See students, boat is starting at point A. It is reaching towards, it should reach B, but instead it is being drifted by the river velocity to C. Therefore, I can write down width of the river W. Width of the river W is equal to Y, which is equal to velocity of the boat into time taken to cross the river. So simply I will write time taken to cross the river is equal to width of the river divided by velocity of the boat. This is number one. Next, number two. X is equal to drift. Drift is equal to distance. Distance is equal to speed into time. Speed is velocity of the river into time taken t. So therefore, X is equal to VR into time taken to cross the river. That is VR into W divided by VB. This is number two. That means the time taken to cross the river. That means if a boat is starting at A, whatever the time it takes to reach B, same time it will be taking in order to drift from B to C. So same time, that's the reason why T W by W by VB I'm substituting here. Next, number three. How do you write VBR bar? VBR, this is the resultant vector, which is sum of AB bar plus BC bar. Is it not? So VBR bar is equal to, what is AB? AB is the vector which is along Y axis, that is velocity of the boat. And it is in which direction? J cap. Plus, what is BC? BC is velocity of the river. And that is in which direction? I cap. So resultant velocity VBR is equal to VB plus VR. This is net velocity of the boat with respect to river. Now coming to some more equations. Check it up, number four now. See, VBR is the vector which is in plane. VBR is in plane. It can be resolved. It can be resolved into components. Right? So when you are resolving this VBR into components, you will get two components, one parallel and the other one is perpendicular, like this. So VBR can be resolved into two components, one component here and the other component here. This angle would be pi. So this becomes, this component is VBR cos pi and this is VBR into sine pi. Okay, so clearly from this you can write magnitude of velocity of the river is equal to VBR sine pi and magnitude of velocity of the boat is equal to VBR into cos pi. Clear? So if resultant velocity is given, you can find out individual velocities of boat and as well as river. And next, now you can take ratio of these two. VBR sine theta or sine pi divided by VBR cos pi. If you take ratio of this, you can write it as VR magnitude divided by VB. VBR, VBR gets cancelled. Therefore, you can write tan theta or tan pi is equal to VR divided by VB. pi is equal to tan inverse of Vr by Vb. This is angle made by the resultant vector with the vertical. Clear? So in this case, boat travel shortest time but longer duration AC. Now I can even find out length AC also. How do you write length AC? AC magnitude is equal to under root x square plus y square. X value, y value we have already calculated, right? X is calculated in number 2 and y is calculated in number 1. You can substitute that x and y values here so that you can find out this distance AC. So how much displacement? This is displacement of boat. Displacement of boat. Right? This is the equation part which will be dealing with the boat when it is traveling perpendicular to the river. And remember, this is downstream. Boat is carried away by the river velocity. As a result, in order to cross the river in shortest time, boat should be rowed perpendicular to the river. Therefore, it takes shortest time but longer duration. Longer length, shortest time it takes, but longer length it travels. And each and everything by resolution of vector into components, you can write down all the unknown quantities from the given situation. Students, boat is starting at position A. It should reach exactly to position B. River velocity is from left to right. This is velocity of the river. It is not equal to 0. In order to reach the other bank exactly, like in order to start from A and to reach B, in which direction we need to row the boat? If there is river velocity from left to right, if you row the boat perpendicular to the river velocity, it will not reach B. Instead, it will be reaching C. Okay, so if the velocity of the boat is perpendicular to velocity of the river, then boat reach C. Is it not? But I don't want this to happen. I want boat to reach exactly to point B. Then in such case, what you need to do, you should make this boat to travel with some angle with the vertical. It may be like this. Right? So velocity of the boat, if it is exactly making some angle with the vertical, if it make an angle pi with the vertical, and if it is rowed in upstream, then in such cases, velocity of the river as it is in this direction, the boat will be drifted from this point to point B. Therefore, in this case, boat take more time but reach shortest displacement. Therefore, in order to cross the river by the shortest displacement, we need to row the boat making some angle pi with the vertical in upstream, right? That is what in this case we will be clearly distinguishing. If we want to reach exactly vertically opposite point, you need to row the boat making an angle pi. And the resultant will be exactly towards A to B. Velocity of boat is this, which is pink color arrow mark. Velocity of the river is with yellow color. And the resultant will be the green. Resultant vector is this. This is the resultant vector. And this should be represented with velocity of the boat with respect to river. Clear? Students, now let us compare both the cases. In the first case, in this case, what we do? Boat, this is point B, this is point A, and this is point C. boat is traveling exactly perpendicular to the river velocity so that it is coming towards the sea. It take shortest time. So here I am considering it as T1, shortest time it take, but longer path it take. AC is the longer path. Now coming to this case 2, you should reach exactly the opposite point B. You are starting at point A. You should reach exactly the point B. In such case, you need to make this boat to travel with some angle with the vertical. Therefore, if it is directed towards C, it is being forced by the river velocity to travel towards B. That's the reason why it starts from A and reach exactly the vertical point. Here time taken is T2. And clearly remember, what is the net displacement in the first case? Net displacement here, it is AC. What is the net displacement here? It is AB, right? So if you compare both the cases, time taken in the first case is less than time taken in the second case, but the displacement AC in the first case is greater than displacement AB in the second case. This is time comparison and this is displacement comparison. Okay. So therefore, in the second case, it should be made to row by an angle theta. In the first case, it is perpendicular. In the second case, it should be rowed with some angle theta. Now we should calculate that angle theta and what is the resultant value. For that, we will be drawing that vector diagram and we'll be finalizing the equations. Students, this is the data which we have already analyzed in the previous slide. VB is velocity of the boat which is in the plane. I need to now resolve that into components. You will be getting two components over there, which are represented with pink color arrow marks. This is VB cos pi. Velocity of the boat is this, and this is VB sin pi. And remember, VR is right side. It is from west to east. VB sin theta is opposite to each other, opposite to VR. Remember, therefore, you need to take this negative sign. Now AC dash B is the triangle which we have. From there, I'll write down from triangle AC dash B. How do you write AC dash? AC dash is equal to AB bar minus BC dash, because they are vector quantities, right? What is AC dash? AC dash is velocity of the boat. Velocity of the boat is equal to AB, that is velocity of the boat with respect to river, and it is J cap, minus of velocity of the boat, velocity of the river, it is opposite to each other, opposite to actual direction. So therefore it is minus of velocity of the river I cap. Clear? Now how do you write VBR? VBR is this resultant, right? VBR is this. So VB is equal to VBR minus VR. You need to remember that. Just vector representation I am taking. VB kavalante AB sum plus BC dash. So just I am taking their sum so that you will be getting VB. Now, this is what we already has, and this is number one. Now let us go for number two. VB can be resolved into components, right? Therefore, VBR magnitude is equal to VB cos pi, and VR is equal to VB sin pi. Just I am writing magnitudes here. If you take ratio of these two, you can write tan pi is equal to tan pi is equal to VB, VB gets cancelled. So it will be VR divided by VBR. That is the angle made by the boat with respect to vertical. That gives you angle tan pi. Clear? That's number two. Next, coming to number three. Here, velocity of the river and VB sin theta both are opposite to each other. Remember that. And VB is velocity of the boat. I am resolving velocity of the boat into components. Right? So time taken here to cross the river, time taken is equal to width of the river divided by velocity of the boat with respect to river. Therefore, time taken here is W divided by, what is VBR written as? VBR can be written as VB into cos pi, or you can write it as W is equal to, what is VBR? VBR is already been written. VBR magnitude can be simply written as VB bar minus of VR bar. This is vector notation. Clear? That is the time taken to cross river, and it is clearly greater than that of the previous case. That's number three. So all we have calculated, right? We have got drift velocity, we have got velocity of the boat, we have got velocity of the boat with respect to river, we have calculated angle pi, everything in this we have calculated, and clearly it's noted that time taken in this case is greater than that of the previous case, previous two cases, but the displacement is very short. Fourth thing is displacement AB bar. What is AB bar? AB bar is nothing but width of the river, right? So AB bar is width of the river. This is displacement of boat. This is displacement of the boat.